The NRZ pulse generator generates a non-return to zero coded electric signal, which is dependent on a bit sequence input. Since the pulse generator's output is dependent on a bit sequence, we will connect a user-defined bit sequence generator to its input. The pulse generator outputs an electric signal, so we will be using an oscilloscope to visualize it. The bit sequence we should expect at the output is dependent on the bit sequence generator and can be seen here. Calculating the project, we can see the output of the pulse generator in the oscilloscope. As you can see, the pulse generator replicates the input bit sequence as the output stays high when the input bit is 1 and goes low when the input bit is 0. The general properties of the pulse generator can be found by double-clicking the block. The rectangle shape property can change the shape of how the pulse transitions from high to low and from low to high. Currently, an exponential shape is selected. Going into the visualizer and zooming in on the pulse, we can see that the transition is curved in an exponential fashion. Going back into the pulse generator and changing the rectangle shape to linear, we can see how that will affect the transition shape. Upon calculating the project, we find that the transition is no longer curved and is now a straight line. Changing format for pulse range from min/max to DC bias/amplitude allows you to alter the DC bias and amplitude of the pulse instead of defining the maximum and minimum of the pulse. In this format, the maximum would be equal to the DC bias plus the amplitude, and the minimum would be equal to the DC bias minus the amplitude. Calculating the project and checking the visualizer, we see that the DC bias is negative 1 and the amplitude is 2, as expected. For the next demonstration, we will revert back to the maximum and minimum format. The position option affects the phase shift of the pulse. With the position set to 0, we go into the visualizer and observe that the transition happens at the start of bit 1. If we are to change the position to 0.5, we will observe that the transition is delayed by 0.5 of a bit. In the general properties of the pulse generator, we can also change the rise time and the fall time. Increasing the rise time will increase the time it takes for the pulse to go from low to high. Increasing the fall time will increase the time it takes for the pulse to go from high to low. Calculating the project and opening the visualizer, we can see the time it takes for the pulse to rise and fall have both significantly increased as expected. Going back to the pulse generator and going into the simulation window, we can modify the sample rate. The sample rate can be changed to take on the value of any other layout parameter or be defined by a function. Pressing evaluate, we can see the value of the sample rate. Sample rate affects the rate at which the pulse generator samples the binary input. Double-clicking the workspace brings up the global parameters window. In this window, the sample rate can be altered. Going back to the pulse generator, we can see that the sample rate has been updated to what we defined it as.